Okay. Let me introduce you about the laboratory exercise for today, right? First of all, you may have to recall about the tree sorting algorithms that we have learned last time, right? That is bubble sort, selection sort, and insertion sort, right? I'm not sure whether you already forgot about the sorting algorithms, but today you may have to recall them again. And today, why do we have to implement it by using the Mathematica program, right? The first thing, the best thing of the Mathematica program is that you sometimes, if you want to show your implementation, if you use C programming, maybe it's not useful or convenient to show you the graph or the graphical image, right, by using the C programming. But for the Mathematica, you can show the result graphically, right? For this example, suppose you want to solve the problem of sorting algorithm, and because there are three kinds of algorithms, but you need to know how to implement all the step of the sorting algorithms. So if you implement it by using C programming, maybe you don't understand at all, right? But if you can see it in the graphical image, it might be easier to understand about this tree sorting algorithms. So that's why I will ask you to use Mathematica programming not to solve this problem. And today PV will tell you about how to use manipulate function. Manipulate function is a built-in function in Mathematica application that is very useful, right? For example, you can see from this figure, you can see that if we random the set of numbers, right? You can see that random number, right? You can also use Mathematica function to run the set, the randomized number, right? And then you can show it on the screen, right? For this one, you can show it easily by using just a few piece of code of Mathematica program, right? And then you can show the step by step by sliding this sliding bar, right? And also, if you want to change the method type, or the sorting type or the sorting method, right? You can just click on the button here, right? And then you can change the algorithm or sorting algorithm automatically. Okay, so today, Tui Chai will show you about how to use Mathematica program in order to solve and show this kind of the graphical image like this. Okay, so I will stop the share and you can share your screen.
Okay, let's start the detail of the laboratory. The first of all, you must implement three sort algorithms. The first one is bubble sort, and the second one is the insertion sort, and the last is the selection sort. So when you see the array will start from the index 0, but in the Mathematica, the index will start from 1. So you must be careful to start from 1 to n. It's not to start from 0 to n minus 1. And I will change this algorithm later. This is a bubble sort. It must change to the insertion sort. I put it wrong. And another thing that you must need to do is you need to show the step. You need to show the step for sorting. So for the input parameter in the common algorithm, you can input only arrays in the Mathematica, but for For showing step by step of sorting, then you need another input is and is the step that you must do to start from step one to step n, and n is the length of the array. After you finish to implement the tree sort algorithm, so you must to implement the manipulate function in Mathematica. The manipulate function has contained three parts. The first one is to display part, that is the code that you want to show anything in the screen. And second part is the control that to control to change value in the variable for showing in the display. For example, it's slider, slider bar or the button. And the last part is optional part. For initialization, you can implement the code or function or algorithm that you want to contain inside the application. In this lab, in the past key, you need to put the sorting algorithm in the initialization part. So we start from the part three, the initialization part. You must put the code of bubble sort, insertion sort, and selection sort in the initialization part. Don't forget to use the comma to separate the part. Every component in the manipulation in the manipulate function will be separated by the comma. The comma will tell the program that this is the part. If you have three controls, it means that you have comma to separate the control. But in the display, if you want to you can show what you can show one thing, for example, in this lab, you need to show a graph. So in the display, you have the command to show only graph, one command to show graph. And if you need to implement or assign value in the variable, you need to use semicolon to separate the statement. But it's not the part you, so there are two symbol for using in separate semicolon to separate the statement in the part, and comma is separate the part. And then mention to the control type part, control path. So if you want to create the control control to change the value of the variables in the display part, you need this syntax. The control will contain in the braces and separated by comma for each control. The first part is in the braces too. It is tell the program that what is the variable name, and the second one is the type of the control. And you can tell the program only the variable name, but if you want any detail of the variable, you must use the braces. The first one in the braces is the variable name. You can declare the variable in the control part. The second is the initial value, and the last one is the alias name. If you want to change name in the when display the control, by default it will use the variable name. Sometimes its variable name is proper to show the user for click or action. So you should change the name by alias name in the third part of the declare variable zone. Then the first control that you need to declare is the available. For example, I need to declare the list. I will put the list in the variable part, and I initial the value of it by the list of number in here, and put it in the initial value. And then I change it to unsort or something like that. And in the control type part of this variable, you can use the button. This button for create the number list random and random the 10 numbers from the range from the range 1 to 100. In this command, I use unsort to be the variable name. A random in this part, random is the name of the button. It's the title of the button, and unsort is the variable name that will be in the part of variable in here. And random sample is the function to random unique function from the list. So if I have 10 elements, I want to random to number. So I will acquire two number that is not to be that are not that are duplicate, that are not duplicate. So in this command, in this function, the random sample will random 10 numbers, random 10 duplicate number from the range 1 to 100. And symbol to apply the result to the unsort variable. This to create the unsort number list, and then I will declare the sorted array for show in the display. So to declare the sorted array, the initial value of sorted array will be the list of set 6.1. And then you can assign the control type will be none. So when you assign the control type is none, it means that this variable will be only variable that show in the display part only. It's not to control anything in the display or interact with the user, not interact with the user. Then you need to add the variable for show the step for sorting. This variable I will name it n, and n will be the slider control slider bar to for user slide to show the result of the sorting step by step. You must to declare by syntax like this. The first one is the variable name is n, and one is the initial value. So I need to start with the step one, and this is the alias name. And the control type path, there are three paths. The first one is the length. It's the beginning of the step, and the second one is the end of the step. So the slider will be start from 1 to 10, and the last one is to jump to the step, or increasing or for increasing by one. Then next, it will start from one, and next step is two, and then three, and so on. And the last variable that you must to declare is the sorting function. The sorting function will tell the program what is the algorithm that you use, what is the sorting function that you use to sort the unsorted list. And you have noticed that there are contained two parts. The first one is the variables, variable declaring. The first one is the name of the variable, sorting function, and bubble sort is the initial value. It means that the program will use bubble sort by default to sort the unsorted list. And the third one is the alias name. The program will show. We show the name of the button is the sorting method. And the second part is the control type. The control type that program will use is the button to select three algorithms. The each three of them will contain two parts. The first one in the first part is the function name. When you implement the bubble sort, you use this bubble sort name to be the name of the function. And insertion sort, this is the name of the function. In the same way, the selection sort is the function that you implement in the initialization part. And this name, it will be the label or alias name that's shown in the button. So in the sorting function, it will be like it will be the process that the program will pass the function name into the display path. It's like to pass the variable in the C programming. When you declare when you implement the function, you have input. It's like the C programming, that the bubble sort, insertion sort, and selection sort is these are the name of the function. Then they pass the name of function to call the function for solve the problem. After you finish the second part to declare the variable for control the display path, then you need to create the display path. The display path has two steps. The first one is assign the result of sorted array by calling the sorting function. The sorting function will pass by the sorting. Pass by the control in the sorting function control in the control part, and need to input. The first one is unsorted array that is declared in the control part too, and then is the step of the sorting. And you can notice that I use the semicolon to do this command first, and then it will show the result in the step S. The step S will use the list part to show the graph of the number. The list part function will put the list of number into the graph. And for your information, the list part function has many options to decide the output or when you want to decide the output, you can press F1 for open hell in the Mathematica, and it will tell you about what control that you can use. For example, you can use the hostile. You can use the hostile to change the color from red to be blue or to be green, something like that. And this is the result of implement. You can see there are three controls. The first one is the unsorted list, and the button to generate list. And the second one is the slider bar to slide for change the step of the sorting. And the third one is the sorting method. But in the lab detail, there are four variables. The sorted list is missing because I use the control type is none, so it's not shown in the control part. And I show you how. The program to do the step by step for sorting. The first one is verbal sort. When you change the step, you can see that the number 9 will to be in the first of the list, to be the first element in the list. And then in the step T is not changed. Step 4 is not changed too. And when go to the step 5, 18 will be the second element in the list. And the next step will not change. The next step, 55, will be insert the next of the 63, and 72 will be put to the seventh element. This is a step of bubble sort. So I change to the insertion sort and go back to the first step. Insertion sort is like to separate two sublists. The first one is sorted list, and the second part is the unsorted list. When the step is two, it means that two elements are sorted. When the step three, you can see that the three elements will be sorted. It will not it won't change until step 8. Next step, the 72 will be to the sorted list. Then the last one, 36 will be inserted into the sorted list in the last step. This is a step of the insertion sort. And the last one is selection sort. Selection sort will select the minimum value in the list first and put it to the first element. Then when go to the second step, number 9 will be the first element. And the next step, 18, will be the second element. And then 39 will be the fourth element. The next step, the 63 will be select and swap to the 100. These are the process of selection sort. For the generating list, you can press the button random to change the list. I will okay, I will show you the range function will be generated the number from 1 to 10 and random sample will select the number will randomly select the 5 number in the list that you provide for the code. For example, in this code range 10, number from 1 to 10 will be randomly select for 5 numbers. And you can use another random function random integer the random integer the first input will be the range of the number from 1 to n. If you put 100, it means that it will random number from 1 to 100. And 5 is number of value that you want to random. If you set 10 to be the maximum of value and random 10 numbers, you can see that there are duplicate number. In this list, the one is the duplicate number. So I use the random sample for solve the problem duplicate number. And then we will implement the manipulator for the mathematical. I implement, for example, I show you two parts of manipulate first. The first part is the display. If you show the value of X, and the second part is control or variable or the decay variable zone. X will be the variable and in this example I use only X, so the variable name will be shown in the control, and 1 and 10 is mean the value that the user can change from 1 to 10, and the program will automate the control type is the slider bar to control the value of X in the display. So when you step forward for the value of X, it will change the value in the display part. The program provide you the increasing step for 0.5, and if you want to increase step by 1, you add comma 1. Then when you step forward, it will change by increasing 1 like this. I need to add another variable is y. After I add, it will you have to control bars. The first one for x and the second one for y. The second slider bar will increase by 2 that I set in the earlier. Then I change the display by X multiplied by Y. Then it will be change the value after we slide the bar or press the step forward button. Then I add the detail of the variable s. So I need to initial it by to be 5 at the start of the program, and I want to change the name that show in the control type part to be the x value. The result will be like this. It will show the x value that I assign the name of the variable x, and the initial will be 5 at the start. And I add another variable is name list and use the control type is none. It will not show in the control type part, control part. And you can assign the list. After you run the program, it will show the value of the list in the display part. Then I don't want to show the value in the list. So, but I want to show the graph of the list. I will use list plot. For the result, when I use the command like this, the program will run automatically and it will compile the command continuously. Then I need to change I need to change the way to show the result. Then I must change the control type to be the button. After I change, when press the button, it will generate the list like this. And then I need to display the graph of the list. And you can see how the program display. It will not similar to the previous one. The program will stop after replace the button random. It will generate the list once after we press the button. What is the point of this? Okay, I run the program again, and you can see that the initial value of list is only one element in the list is one, and you can see the graph will be show the one point. After I press the random, it will show you 10 points. The x-axis show you the index of the list, and the value will display in the y-axis. You can change the color. By using the option for style. If I have 1, 2, 3. When you change the font size, and you use the red color to be the color of the point, the point will be red. Or you can assign the size of the point like this in the font size. Or you can create the polygon of the point. You can connect the line for each point. You can use this option join to be true. It will be the line. It will not show the point. When you random, it will be the graph like this. If you want to show both point and line, you can use the command like this, and you can use the word list. The first one is list of. The first one is a list that try the point, and the second one is the list that is not try the point. You can see the result. The result will show both point and the line. But the point will not red that we assign in the first. Then you can change. You want to change the color of the point. You can use the function like this. Use option like this. The first one is red. Red is the line because you can see you can reference by join option. The first one is true. It means to create the line for join two points. And four is to show only points. And the red will be the line. Will be the color of the line, and the blue is the color of the point. And if you want to add more option, you must add braces to add the option to display in the manipulation. I need tick line. Then I add tick. You can see that the line is thicker than the previous one. For more information or more information, you can click the list part and click the information button or press F1. When you press F1, this page will be shown. And it show you the basic examples to use list part function. you can expand the options and then find the example of the option to display a graph. For example, the filling will fill the line from the point to the axis. In this example, the line will be filled from top to the point and point to the bottom, point to the axis and to the specific value. Is the plot style. You can see this code, the plot style PS. The PS will be assigned for red, for assigned large, darker green. The first one will show in the first figure, and the second one is show the second figure, and so on. For the initialization part, you type initialization and then type the colon and then followed by the greater symbol. It will change to be the symbol like this. I create the example function and there are three parameters. The first one is list and then is x and y, and the operation is list multiplied by x and plus y. I add a new variable, new list, and new list. We will call the example function. For the code, new list will call the exponent function to generate the new list of value, and on pod I will assign for the graph the graphic that pod the list variable, and the new pod will be the graphic that to pod the new list, and I use this command to use the labeling command that the point in the new list will be labeled by new list. For example, it will the value of the new list, the first element is 7, it will be labeled by 7. And the show function will collect all the graphics to display at the S1 screen. When you press the random, you can see that the new point will be born than the old one. This is the example for use the manipulate function in the Mathematica. Do you have any question, or do you want more example? What is initialization? Initialization is a part for declaring your custom function. In this lab, you must put the bubble sort function, insertion sort function, and the sorting selection sort function to the initialization. Initialization like you declare the function in the C programming that you declare its name first, and then you implement it later after main. So if you can declare the example or implement example function this like this to the outside of manipulate. If you be the COBOL function, that manipulate can know this function. When you close the program or close the kernel, the manipulate will cannot detect the example when this function is outside of the manipulate. If you put it in the manipulate, it will be the local function for the manipulate. When you close the program or close the kernel, and you can run directly in only manipulate, it will know the example function. Yes, it is similar to variable initialization for a specific function. Yes, it is similar. It's like to declare the inner function. Yes, if you compare with C, it's like a local variable, but this is a function, so it's inner function for the manipulate function. So only inside the manipulate can know the example function. I will show you if I comment the initialization part and I quit the kernel. If I run this example, this function before, and then I will run the manipulate, the program will perform correctly. And then I will quit kernel again. Okay, now the example function will not be declared in the metadata. And then I run only manipulate function. So you can see that it cannot find the example function. So the result will be show the error like this. After I put the example function into the initialization, it will be run correctly. Why doesn't work? Before I run the manipulate, I remove the initialization part and I didn't run the example function. So you can see when I quit the kernel and start it again, you can see the color of the function name, it will be blue. It is blue. The blue color of the name of the name of variable and the function is mean. The program is not legit. It's not legit the name of function or variable. If the function will be known by the program, it will be turned the color from blue to black. Then you can see that the example function will be blue. So it means that the program will not register the example function into the program. So when you run the manipulate, what is turn? Okay. You can see example is put to the global function, but manipulate cannot know the example function is still blue. And the error will show that we show the error about the example function like this. It cannot find this function to perform the way to perform the result of the list. But if you run the example function, the name will be the back color, and then it means that the program will know the example function when you run it, will can perform the program correctly. So I need you to create the initialization path to declare the local function. When you start the program and run, you can run only the manipulate function. You don't want to run another function outside the manipulate. Any questions? If not, it's now your turn to do the laboratory. separate function in the initialization or control. Initialization, I show you only one function. Then I add another function. And I get the module. When you use the module as a function, the module function will be the function like C programming that you can create by coding the sequence of command in the function. But the first thing that you need to know, you cannot change or edit the value in the input. When you receive the list as input, you cannot change its value. The input can only get the value from them. So if you want to change the value of the input, so you need another variable to assign the value of the input to this variable. You can see the initialization part. You can there are two functions and it's separated by the semicolon. After you finish implement this function, you need to put the semicolon for separate each function. you use semicolon to separate the functions and to control. The semicolon will separate the command and the component of the, in the manipulation will be separated by comma. You can see the comma in the first comma to separate the display part and the control part. Each control part, it will separate the controls by comma. Controls or variable by it will separate by comma. You can see each carrying the variable will be separated by comma. Can see the result like this. When you have two functions, you separate by semicolon, and when you have many components, you separate by comma. In this slide, we will plot new list. New list is assigned by experiment one function. The result will be the points above the graph, above the other graph. You can see that if I remove the second part of them. It will show only points. And I need to label the value of each point in the new list. So I use this command. The new list will be labeled by new list, by the value of new list. When I run, it will show the value as the label of the point. Apivit, it cannot slide to see the step. What does it mean? It cannot. Like it is stuck at 10. Can you show me your code that you create the slider control? The program can be run. Oh, I see. Go to the go up. You remove and you hold ten. It's like. And then it starts from the first. your result will be like this because when the step is when the n is one, you only generate the sorted list only one element. When the step is five, you only generate the you have only five elements in the sorted list. You can see, for example, the bubble sort that you create in the command array equal table. You can see that the table will be copied the element of the array from one to n. So when the program is run and it will show the element number of element equal to the number of steps. For simplify this code, you can assign directly arr equal array directly.